Bless me, Lord. Good morning. Good morning. This is Sunday. We're about to go to church. We're going to do the early morning service. We got a 7, a 9, and 11, but we're going to do a 7 a.m. I'm hoping my daughter meet me at church. She's got to work afterwards. She may not. I got to work a little bit later on today, too. Okay, so we got some coffee going on. I like this, you guys. This is International Delight, and it's in chocolate Hershey's. Girl, it's really good. I don't need no sugar or anything, but I really like it. I'm not a big coffee drinker, but I will drink it, you know, to set the mood for Sunday morning. And plus, my commute to church is about 30 to 40 minutes. So, we're listening to some Twinkie Clock. Do what we need to be doing. Told Elisha, you got 15 more minutes. Let's go. So, yeah, we're doing one of them. Okay. Come on with me for a minute. Y'all know about Twinkie? Yeah. Is he awesome, girl? Is he awesome? You better know it. Okay. This is what we're doing, y'all. Check this out. This is a little, I got two sweater dresses. You know, sweater dresses do us very well. So that's what we're doing. The pantyhose. I was going to do some boots, but what I'm going to do, we're going to keep it simple. We're going to keep it simple, you know? So that's what we're doing. And we're taking the real Bible. You know one thing that I do? No judgment. But I don't look at the word on the phone. You know how technology has really taken over with a lot of stuff? But I don't do that, you guys. You know what I'm saying? I got a couple of Bibles up here. I got Study Bible, Woman's Bible, one of my first Bibles, you know, my mother's Bible. That's the one that I use, that I've been using for years, is my mom's Bible. And I take an actual Bible. You know what I'm saying? Where is my Bible at while I'm talking? Girl, it's up here. I just had it down here on my library. Okay, this is my, you know, my good. Okay, so yeah, you guys, it's the last Sunday of the month, so. It's been a couple of weeks since I went to church, and they like, I'll make it in every Sunday, but you know what? What is placed on my heart, I go to congregate, you know what I'm saying? So I do believe in worshiping, okay? It's a good thing. All right, I'll be back, y'all. Bye.
Y'all. It is still dark out here because we're going to a 7 a.m. But the sun will shine. So, anyway, I was looking for my burgundy gloves with fur, girl. I ain't got no blue on. But anyway, we're going to keep the hands warm because it's only about 50-something degrees this morning. So, that's what we're doing. Anyway, be back. Be blessed. We're here waiting on Elisha. He better come on. He's ready, though. Told him to go on and lock the door and come on, and I'm warming up Bertha. Oh, what you doing? How you feeling? What you doing? I got my coffee. When I turn you off, then I'll turn me some gospel on. But you know what? The radio. You see what they're doing. Sometimes they be doing gospel early.
Smooth shave, smooth price, big flips.
Just depends, I guess, what channel, right? Anyhow, got my Bible, got my glasses, all that good stuff. But where is my gloves at? I gotta think. Girl, because they would match so perfect with my sweater. I got some burgundy gloves with the fur on them, girl. So, let's go on and meet that. You know, we gotta set the atmosphere. That's what it's always about. Come on, boy, what's taking you so long, son? Okay, I'll be back. Let me call him.
Through you and I. Jesus said unto them, I am the way, the truth, and the light. No man cometh to the Father but by me. While ye have light, believe in the light, that ye may be children of the light. guides. It directs us which way we need to go along life's pathway. I am the light of the world, and whosoever believeth in me shall not die, but have everlasting life. Life strips away darkness.
This little light of mine, oh, don't let it shine. Oh. Leaving church and looking here, always something. I just got my tires rotated and now I'm on the interstate. I had to pull over. I think one of my tires are busted. So we got AAA and we can, you know, call X or call the right now one. So they're gonna swap me out and handle me all up. So it's good for, you know, it's good for women, especially single women, to have AAA or something to help us in these distressed times. So we thank God for that. All right. Okay, now on to the next episode. So actually that was the sheriff courtesy that fixed my tire. So I had a spare. I didn't know that I had. AAA just called me and I said, I thought that's who's fixing my tire. And they was like, no, we're on our way. And I said, well, the sheriff department a courtesy patrol done did it. So thank God. All right, let me pay attention and get on home safely. Okay, so when we talk about grace and mercy, those are some of the things that we look at, because small things like that could have been a disaster, could have been someone hurt, anything of the above. But thank God for his mercy, his grace, his covering, you know what I'm saying? So that all, you know, no hurt, harm, or danger. So those are the things that I pay attention to and that I recognize and I realize, okay? So, but I'm gonna stop over here where I got the tires at on my truck, because I should have a warranty. And I got some time and they open on this Sunday. So I'm gonna do that and talk to them. I'm gonna try not to be kind of, you know, because the young man who did my tires and rotated them earlier last week, couple days ago, he over-aired my tires. So, you know, that type of stuff is important. And here people, you know, you have your families and everything that's traveling in these cars. And so these mechanics, these people who's working on people's cars need to know what they're doing. You know what I'm saying? So we just thank God, you know, all in all, because man can always fail you. You know what I'm saying? And they can make a mistake or what have you. So, but yet and still, if he's there or whatever, I'm going to let them know that it still needs to be looked at, because the next person may not be that lucky. So, let me see. We're going to get off here. We ride around there. All right, I'll be back. I'm just waiting on the manager. I talked to one young man and he said that all he could say was sorry. You know, a sorry doesn't do when a person really gets hurt or something. I'm here to tell it. But, you know, probably was over, you know, for over airing the tire or what have you. So it's good to hear you say you sorry. But maybe need some more training or something like that, or just understand, because people's lives are on the road in these vehicles. So anyway, we're gonna wait on the manager, get this taken care of this Sunday. Okay, so even with my warranty, I have to pay a portion based on the tread of the tire, which makes sense. So he said I got about 75 to 80% of the tread from when I got him. It's getting warm, so I have to pay for another tire. They're trying not to really take the blame about over airing it. He claimed it was a valve on the tire, and he was saying that the valve on the other tire needed to be changed, which he did for free. So the tire is going to be $90 based on the amount of tread, because the tire itself was like $170 a piece. So I have to wait till next week, get that tire on here. So we're just gonna roll with my spare. I'll probably drive my other car, do like that. But trucks have a big old spare, just like a regular tire. Actually, it's a regular tire, not like a donut, so that's a good thing. Let's see, I need to go back out. So I have to do a couple hours at the store today, because it is Sunday. Go home, lay down for a minute, cook Elisha something, probably do some, I don't know, cook him some pancakes or something. And that'll be that. That'll be that. So, anyhow, all is well. We made it through the episode. And, no harm done. Peace. All right, let's go in here and cook this boy some pancakes and eggs. How about that? Hey, y'all. We out of the church clothes and all, and we doing some pancakes and some eggs real quick, okay? And, that's about it. I wanted to go get a workout in, actually. I still might, but right now I'm going to feed this child, and then I'm going to sit down and relax for a little bit. Just have my hat on my head. So, anyhow, yep, Christmas tree still up. Yep, yep. End of January, Christmas tree still up. Mm-hmm. I like the essence. Disclaimer. Cover your ears. Girl, I cannot sing, but I love trying to, okay? If there's some music that I really like, so cover your ears. I cannot sing, but I love music that I like, and I try to sing it.
Yes, come on, Twinkie. In the Bible days, to heal the sick and take the pain away. But there's some news in the Bible days. Come on, girl. Yeah, yeah. Yeah. I'm just acting up. Hey, you guys. Girl, this is linen right here. This is another piece of linen that I purchased at the store there. I'm gonna go do a couple hours. And look at these earrings, girl. They are so pretty. The starfish. Yeah. I'm giving you wig effect today. Wig. Okay. Just all good. So, anyhow, that's what we got going on. And we wear some Levi's. Girl, let me tell you. These are some mama jeans for real. These are Levi's. And I got these at JCPenney's. So, you need to go, you know, if you a mama, you know, all of this right here, what we be dealing with, girl, they do it. They like cover all that up for you. Yeah, just like that. So yeah,
You know, one of my main things that I think about when I do this little part-time job is to make somebody smile, okay? So when somebody's coming through and I'm cashiering, I want to make them smile. I want to talk to them. It's Sunday, you know, so I do always do Sundays. You know what I'm saying? Just a couple hours. But I know that the point is to make somebody smile, to give somebody hope. You know what I'm saying? To let somebody know that, hell, they beautiful, or let them know that all will be well, or a listening ear. You'd be surprised, girl. Let me tell you something. You'd be surprised how many women, like, come through the line. Men, too, but women, you know what I'm saying? They got stuff going on, and they talk to me and stuff right there at the register, girl. So, yeah, yeah. God can use us in any form, any dimension, all that, all that. So don't be closed-minded, you know what I'm saying, down to even the jobs that you have or what you do personally or just raising your children or taking care of your parents, your sisters or brothers, you know, or friends, whatever, whatever. You know what I'm saying? God uses you right there. So be an inspiration to someone. All right, y'all. Bye. John P. Key, When the Gates Swing Open. We will be there. All right now. Girl, I love these earrings. Thank you, Lord. That's right. Girl, Kobe Bryant. I'm on my way. Do what I need to do, but Lord, I tell you. Okay, you guys. Girl, not even 5 minutes ago, I'm walking out the door to go to this store for a couple hours, and Elisha tell me Kobe Bryant just passed about 10 minutes ago. Oh, Lord. Man, you know when we hear about celebrities or people or sports or rap music or R&B, you know, whoever, but people that we grew up with, or turn this heat off, it's hot. You know, it's like, yeah, I'm giving you wig today, you guys. I'm giving you wig right now, not today, but right now, because I started, I started my day without my wig. Well, without a wig. I wore a hat, though. Oh, girl. So sad. Sad, but, you know, 41 years old. Girl, and it's like he was in a helicopter. Something to that sort. Girl, 41. Wasn't he retired, though, too? I mean, he wasn't in the game no more. So he was just enjoying his, you know, luxuries of life. You know what I'm saying? And I'm pretty sure he gave back and all that good stuff. And hopefully he was a believer. And girl, I don't know. I don't even talk about where people go and all that stuff, you know. I need to make sure I make it in, okay? So, I don't know. I just be like, wow. And I'm not no basketball. I mean, I'm not a basketball fan. I'm not no basketball person that, like, you know, I follow the sport, because I don't. But everybody know his name, right? Like Shaquille O'Neal, right? Girl. You just shake your head because it's like, oh, I'm sorry, you know, to their family, friends, children, wife, mother. Oh, my goodness. Girl, death is a part of life, as they tell us, right? Because if you watching me and I'm up here talking, I'm still here, right? Girl, but death, you know, I've succumbed and come to a place now where, you know, I respect the fact that it's a part of transitioning. It's a part of life, and ain't none of us gonna get up out of it. So you ain't gonna get up out of it. I'm not gonna get up out of it. Man. But we just don't really think about stuff like that on a regular. You know what I'm saying? So, girl, I got this thing right here because I be forgetting sometimes. So I'm gonna put it right there. But girl, anyway, it's been a good day. It's been a busy day. A busy Sunday. It started off, went to early morning service, me and Elijah. I wanted Chris to go, my daughter. She got to work today and stuff, but we had planned that she was supposed to come to church with me and stuff, but she wasn't able to make it. But church was good. They talked about shining your light, you know, and girl. When we pass, our light is out. That's it. That's all she wrote. You know what I'm saying? The Bible talks about a man and his dreams is gone after that. You know what I'm saying? So, but he also talks about death. Where is your sting? You hear me? You know? Where is your sting? You know? So, you know, you guys, I don't know. I ain't no guru, but I do know I'm a spiritual woman, regardless, you know? And my precepts, you know, how I look at stuff or how I feel about, you know, things of that nature, they work for me. So, anyway, I hope that you're having a very good day and that you are not allowing, you know, any negativity to succumb you or bother you. I hope that you are handling your business, whatever it may be. If it's even to sweep that kitchen floor, I hope you're handling your business. You know, gotta do what we gotta do. 1 minute at a time. That's it. Ain't nobody perfect. We all doing this together, believe it or not. You know? Service was good. We had a guest speaker and he spoke on shine your light, you know, and all that good stuff. And I'm pretty sure I said something about that earlier, but you know, and it's true. We do need to shine our light. We do need to, you know, be positive, because shining your light, not only about Christ, but shining your life just in the decency of being a person, in the decency of helping somebody, in the decency of just smiling. You know what I'm saying? Give a person a smile. Hell, it makes a difference to some people. Girl, I am so serious. You never know where people's minds are at. You know? What's going on? You know? And a lot of us can count our blessings. You feel me? I'm talking about a lot of us can count our, especially, I'm going to say this, especially over here in America. You know? I don't know where you watching from all over the world, but I know here in America, they need to count their blessings. You know, it's a lot of stuff going on, but it's a butt there. Anyway, let me get up off of that. Okay, you guys, I'm gonna pay attention. I'm gonna get up in here. I'm wearing this linen here. Girl, I love these colors. These earrings are everything. I put a wig on. I really need my hair. I wanna be lined up, but I'm waiting until I leave for my getaway, Jamaica. So I'm waiting. So this time next week, I'll be there. But right now, I gotta handle where I'm at, right? So we stay in the now, we stay in the moment. So yeah, I hope that you have prayed, that you are good, and that your family is good, your friends, your all that, finances. You know, we speak blessings upon all that. So, yeah, I'm one of them. And then catch me in another video, and I'm cussing and fussing. I'm one of them. Okay? Don't get it distorted. Don't get it twisted. Just understand that I'm human. And if I can help somebody understand that, shit, I've done my job for this Sunday. Because God is good. He forever will be. So, you know. Oh, girl. So, anyway, I'll be back later. All right. Peace out. Bye.